going to learn how to install Redis. And this installation doesn't really require any root access, or it doesn't also require internet to be available on the server. So probably in your production environment, this is going to be the preferred way of downloading this software and preparing the package and then installing it. Okay, so for this one, I'm just going to follow the documentation which is mentioned in the Redis documentation. And please note, this is not going to be any cluster installation. This is a standalone installation. So the first thing which we need to do is we need to run wget command and download the package which is available at this URL. So wget command just going to download this package, and then the command line second, which is tar space xvzf, and then the name of the software. So this is just going to extract whatever we have downloaded, because the download version is in zipped format. So the second line extracts that format. And then once we extract it, there is going to be a Redis hyphen stable directory created. So we are going to do cd space redis hyphen stable. So basically we are moving into that directory, and then we are going to run make command. So what make will do is it is going to create a bundle of all the, basically based on the source package, it is going to create the bundle which we can use to start or stop Redis. So let's run all of these commands one by one. So if I do id, you can see currently I'm logged in as a root user. So let me change it to a normal user. So I have another user created which is called Redis admin. So if I do id now, or who am I now, you can see right now I'm logged in as a Redis admin user. Okay, so now we will follow the steps which are mentioned in this documentation. So I'm copying first command and then I'm going to paste it here. Okay, so if I do ls-lrt, you will notice right now what has happened is this software has been downloaded, and we have a file which is called redis-stable.tar.gz. So the second command which we need to run is, let's check that in the documentation. So basically we run the tar command using xvzf, and we also give the name of the file which is a zipped file. Okay, so I'm just going to copy paste this file which we have downloaded, and once we do that, it is going to extract this file. Let's clear the screen and let's do ls-lt again. Now we can see there is a new folder which has been extracted, which is called redis-stable. So let's go inside redis-stable, and here if we do ls-lt, this is the structure, you know, which it looks like. So if we follow the documentation, now we need to run make command. So let's do that. Type make and press enter. So basically what it is doing is we had downloaded the source file, so it is going to compile all of those files and going to prepare the binaries which can be used to start Redis services. It is going to take some time, usually it takes a couple of minutes. So by the way, Redis by default runs on a port which is 6379. So just make sure before installing Redis that port number 6379 is available, or if port number 6379 is being used by any other application, then you can actually change this port from 6379 to some other port in the configuration file. Okay, so make command has been executed successfully. So as it says, it's a good idea to run make space test. So if you want, you can do it, or if you want to ignore it, you can ignore it. So I'm going to clear the screen and let's follow the documentation. And now actually we can see that, you know, it just says we can start the Redis server by moving onto SRC folder. Okay, so let's go back and let's do ls-pwd. So right now you know where I am, so I'm into redis-stable directory. If I do ls-lt now, this is the directory structure you will see by default. So I will do cd space src and then I will do ls-lt again. Okay, so this is the directory which contains redis-server utility. Okay, so if I just scroll up, I can see redis-server utility. This is the utility which we need to use to start Redis server. So I'm going to clear the screen first, and if I just run redis-server, it is going to start the services if port 6379 is available. Okay, but let's say this port is not available. So what we can do is, let's do ls. We don't need to do ls. So basically I wanted to go one level back, and we need to find out redis.conf. Yeah, so redis.conf file is available here. So it is available at the path of redis-stable. So I'm going to open this file using vi editor. And now you can search for 6379. Okay, so here you can see in this file it has been configured that port number 6379 is going to be used by default. So I'm going to change it to 6370. Okay, again, if you don't want to make any changes and you are sure that port number 6379 is available, you can just ignore this step. But if the port number 6379 is used by any other application and you want to change the port, or for any other reason you want to change the default port to any other port, then you can make that change here and then save this. And then now we can go back to SRC folder. This is a folder where we have redis-server available. So as by default, if I run this redis-server, it is actually not going to read that configuration file which is available there. So we also need to supply the path of the redis-conf file. So my redis.conf file is available at one folder or one level back. So for that one we do ./, and then we can give the path of the file. Okay, so this is how I'm going to start redis-server, and let's hit enter. So now you can see it is saying Redis has been started successfully and it is ready to accept connection. You can read this line here. And also if you scroll little up, you can see that the port on which it is listening on is 6370 and the process ID is 21347. Now to stop this, since I have started this in interactive mode, I have not started this as a background process. So I'm still on to that prompt. So if I press Control-C or Control+C rather, then it is going to be cancelled and these services is going to be stopped. Okay, so now if I want to start it as a background service, so I will also put ampersand sign in there and then we can run this. Okay, but before we do that, I would also like to show you one more thing. Okay, so right now I'm in this directory and if I go one level back and here if I try to run redis-server and hit enter, you see I get the error that redis-server command is not found. Okay, or let's say I go back to the home directory of this user and if I do pwd, you can see right now I'm in the home directory of redis admin user. And if I try to run redis-server or redis-server, it is just saying that there is no such command available. The reason being is this utility is only available inside src directory. Okay, if you do ls-lt and redis-server, okay, you can see this utility is available here. And by default, operating system doesn't know, or it doesn't know where to, you know, look for this redis-server. Because by default, whenever you type the name of any utility, it tries to look for those utilities in the, you know, in all the path which is available under the path environment variable. So now let's say if I want to run this redis-server command from any directory, or regardless of, you know, which directory my current position is. So for that one, you need to update your path variable. So for that, you need to run something like export space path. And guys, this syntax which I'm going to type right now, this works on a CentOS machine. So please check on the operating system on which you are running this, what is the way to update the path variable. But if you are on CentOS, you can follow this. Know whatever I am doing. So I am updating this path with this path. So what it has done is in the path variable it has also added this directory. So now if I go back to my home directory, I will do pwd. So now you see my current position is /home/redis-admin. However, if I do redis-server and hit enter, it is not going to give me error this time. It is basically going to run. Okay, so I don't want to just do redis-server because I also need to pass the, you know, file name of the configuration directory. Otherwise, it is not going to take the port number 6370 which we have passed. So let me also provide it the full path of the redis.conf file which we have just edited. So you can keep the configuration file at any location. Just make sure when you run redis-server command, you also pass the name of the, you know, complete path of the file where that file exists. Okay, so this is how I'm going to run it, and also I'm going to write ampersand in the end. So what this going to do is it is going to run Redis in the background. So just notice we have, you know, we are currently in Redis admin working directory, or present working directory position is /home/redis-admin. And still we'll be able to run redis-server command. Let's hit enter. And now we can see again that Redis has been started. It is saying ready to accept connections. And also the port which it is running on is 6370 and the process ID is 21855. Okay, now if I hit enter again, I'll be getting back to this prompt. But please notice Redis services are still running and we can verify it by using ps-ef command. ps-ef command shows us list of all the processes, and then I will use grep command and I will pass Redis. So it will search any processes which is running with name Redis, and once we hit enter we can see. So basically this is the process which is running, and this is having the process ID of 21855. So if you had noticed here, when we started this service, it has also shown us what is the process ID. So this process ID and this process ID is matching, so Redis is still running. Now to log into Redis, if you go back to redis-stable directory and then you go on to src directory, you will notice there is also a command line utility which is called redis-cli, which exists at under src directory. So now since we have set the path of src directory, so now we will be able to run all the utilities or any executable which exist inside this path. So I can run this redis-cli from anywhere. I don't need to go back to this directory in order to run redis-cli. So I will go back to the home directory and I will show you my present working directory, and then we will type redis-cli, and this is a command line interface which is provided by Redis to interact with Redis server. So if I hit enter, okay, so by default Redis CLI also connects to port 6379. Okay, so when we have made a change in the port and we want to run Redis command line interface, then we also need to use -p to specify the port on which Redis server is running. So here I'm going to pass 6370, and now you can see it has connected to Redis command line interface. Now there are a couple of commands which I'm just going to execute to make sure that Redis is running and we are able to interact with Redis. But we'll be discussing about these commands later on in more detail. So basically if you want to write any key value to Redis, so for that one you use set command, and notice whenever you type set, it started giving you some of the description. So that is the feature of Redis command line interface. So here let's say I want to enter the price of the products. So probably I'll enter the price of chair, and then we enter the price of table. And when I want to see the price of these objects again, so I need to write get and followed with the key name. So here this chair is a key name, table is a key name, and the value which we have passed is followed with the space. So if I do get space chair, I'm going to get the value of chair, which is 600. If I do get table, I'm going to get value of table, which is 700. If I want to see how many total keys which has been inserted or which is available in Redis, so for that one we do db size. It will tell us total number of keys which are available right now in Redis. So right now there are two records which we inserted, so we see the output as 2. If I want to see all the keys which are available in Redis, so for that one you can type keys followed by star. You can see we have two keys inserted, which is chair and table. Okay, so we can see Redis is already installed and we are able to interact with Redis, and also we have successfully made a change in the port.